Hi, I'm Max Searman.
Hi, I'm Dean Utell, and we are presenting our project, the PanicPauser.
Currently in America, 40 million adults suffer from anxiety attacks. That is about 18% of the US population.
During an anxiety attack, people begin producing adrenaline. This is completely normal, except that when you're experiencing an anxiety attack, you'll be producing high adrenaline levels more often, which after a while can cause harmful effects on a person's heart.
Some ways to stop anxiety attacks are to introduce soothing stimuli before the person having the anxiety attack. The PanicPauser uses this idea to introduce soothing sound, light, and smell to calm a person down. Using a pulse sensor, the PanicPauser can detect when people's heart rate gets too high. This will indicate an anxiety attack and activate all of its functions, allowing for the user to be calmed down before the anxiety attack can cause too much damage for the user's body.
The device is necessary because it uses multiple factors to calm the user down, instead of just one. This increases the likelihood of allowing the user to come out of their panic attack. The PanicPauser also only costs $27.55 to produce, making it inexpensive to the public.
This is our project, the PanicPauser. In order to activate the PanicPauser, we are using a pulse sensor. But since the pulse sensor isn't giving us accurate data right now, we are currently using a photoresistor to start the project. When you press the photoresistor, a stepper motor will open up a door, which releases a scent and a pill that the user can take. At the same time, a light show and a sound start to play, which is supposed to calm the user down. The lights appear in alternating blue and white lights. As the song and the light show comes to an end, the stepper motor will close the door. Over the year, we experienced some problems. One of them was when we started the year using a heart rate monitor. The heart rate monitor would only work when the user remained completely still. Due to this, we switched to using a pulse sensor rather than a heart rate monitor. Unfortunately, our pulse sensor also didn't give the most reliable data, so we are currently using a photoresistor to activate the project.
If we had more time, we would find a better heart rate monitor and pulse sensor. This would allow us to take accurate data of the user, making our project start at the right time.
Thank you for watching.